just want them to get better, and we want to help them any way we can in achieving that. And then it raises the dropout age to 18. I got to tell you, I had most problem with that one.
Yeah.
But as part of the compromise, I voted yes.
Yeah. You know what, on that, we all, there are some kids that just don't want to be there, but I think the value of this is it says we're a state that expects kids get to 18, that and not just leave early, and that we should accommodate their needs. It might be the virtual learning or the online learning, and it helps us do that. In terms of 5%, I need to tell you candidly, it's the most challenging for us as a department. I've got to appoint a reform officer that'll be on our staff under this. We're happy to do this, by the way, because we mm-hmm. think out of 4,000 schools, this will mean about 200 schools will be under the jurisdiction of the Department of Ed. I'll have a deputy superintendent / reform officer. We'll try to work. I need to name these schools by September 1.
Uh-huh.
And then they have 60 or 90 days, I forget, to try to have a proposal to show how they're going to improve. And I would say to your audience right now, if there happen to be any schools in that area, we want them to have a proposal that works. We don't really want to have to own those schools
right,
because it's
right.
best. But if they don't have a proposal that's going to be able to show student growth, I mean, we have, I think it's 140 schools in this state where less than 5% of the kids are proficient.
Oh, my.
I mean, they're done. So this was our opportunity, and the legislature and the governor stepped up to it, which is once and for all, we've got to say that if worst case scenario, we're going to own them. We've got a lot of leverage in this set of laws to deal with those schools once and for all. Because, I mean, to me, I know I can just tell from knowing you for a while, but also your tone, you wouldn't want your kids or your grandkids to go to some of these schools, so
no,
we shouldn't let anyone go.
Yeah.
But we're going to try to help them improve, and if in the final analysis they don't, we're going to put them into what's called a reform district, run by the reform officer, who would also then be a superintendent, and this would be, in effect, like a statewide district, and try to make it work that way.
Now, it's not specific in this particular law, but what kind of flexibility are you going to have to put added resources into a school like that?
You know, unfortunately, we won't have any added resources. What it'll mean is in time, we won't as a department. If we had to actually take over some of these schools, and I'm sure that'll be maybe 50-50, and let's say 100 schools end up in the department, we would get the per pupil funding with that, so
yeah.
In that sense. But what all of these schools have and have had for a while is there is federal money that goes into these so-called struggling schools.
Yeah,
so
that's right.
Supplemental
that's
money.
No Child Left Behind did that,
right.
didn't they? Yeah,
exactly.
Okay.
And we have some even extra money if we win Race to the Top in there.
But you know, we ought to talk. If it turns out that resources are part of the problem and we're committed to helping those schools, I'm an approps guy, so we ought to sit down
well,
and talk.
You know, since you brought it up, I mean, frankly, we're down to 10 people in the department funded by the state.
Uh-huh.
We have a couple of hundred funded by the feds. And I can't use them for state work. So we do have a supplemental in right now as a request because, for instance, I have to hire a reform officer. I can't use federal money for that. And there has to be at least some infrastructure around that person. So we're hoping that the legislature and the governor will help us with that. Because that, you know, to even go over these proposals, the 200 proposals that are going to come in, and to do justice to them, to see... You need to visit, you need to interact with the staff of each of those buildings, you need to have experts at our department, you know, more than the 10 people we have that are actually going to be able to say, this looks like it's going to work, keep working at it, we're going to monitor you. So we're going to have a supplemental request for this current year, and then we're going to submit additional requests for a permanent infrastructure. You can't have a reform officer in
Boy,
a division.
I opened the door in that one, didn't
well,
I?
Well, you did, you know, and I wouldn't have, but I can't thank you enough because we've been worried about it. We don't want to do a bad job. And mm-hmm. for the districts to get an opportunity to hold these kids, that's going to be their goal. They're not going to want to give up their foundation money for, let's say, 200 kids at a school, 2,000 kids at a high school.
Yeah.
But for us to review these proposals, we need some staff to do that. And I know that it's been talked about by both the Senate mm-hmm. and the House, so we very much appreciate it, and we'll do the best we can.
Well, if we have time at the end of this thing, I'll tell you how we can take a couple million out of the cost of government without sending anybody out the door.
Okay.
And that's where we could find a way to help you with what you've just talked about.
Okay.
The next one is House Bill 5596, and it requires you as Superintendent of Public Instruction to talk about an alternative path to certification for teachers and administrators. And we've touched on it a little bit, but you might want to talk some more.
Yeah, I think we did a pretty good job, because we want to have this way that you as an engineer, you need to know about how kids learn, but you don't need to learn math all over again and demonstrate it with credits that are costly. I think for administrators, it's also something new, because in a way, we've never looked for training of administrators. It's wide open in terms of what it is to be an administrator, at least for the last 10 or 15 years. So this is really an opportunity to say, here's a pathway to become a principal that might not be the traditional one. You know from your experience that we do have people who have had leadership experiences in outside the education world who come in and can actually offer something.
Sure.
And let's take advantage of it.
In fact, I have classmates who, when they finish their time in the military, are now teachers. It turns out that people who sort of service-oriented wind up preaching, teaching, politics, the military, some kind of service thing, as opposed to being captains of industry.
It's in our blood.
Yeah,
it's
I guess
in
that's
blood.
It.
You're right.
Before I forget, we've used an acronym ISD. That stands for Intermediate School District.
Right.
Now, the Intermediate School District, will that be able to help resource-wise, people-wise, with failing schools, or are they sort of out of that part of the system?
They're not in the reform officer picture, but where we do use them even right now is we use federal money we get that we give to the ISDs to help us in Oakland and Wayne, and particularly the counties with the largest so-called struggling schools population, whether it's Detroit or Pontiac. And so Chris at Wayne, Vicky at Oakland, they really have resources now through federal money to engage some of their folks into that direct process. But in terms of the reform office, that's now a whole other issue. That's saying all of those measures failed and that they still have less than 5% of their kids proficient. So it takes it up to another level. And I think just the pressure of that will help people be motivated to make sure they improve dramatically so that it doesn't get to kind of a takeover stage.
Well, we're running out of time. It went much faster than I thought it would. You've been an interesting guest, and I really appreciate your being here.
I'm happy to be here.
At another time, we'll talk about how we lower the cost of government without sending anybody out the door.
Okay.
Big time.
Okay.
And again,
that's a deal.
I thank you so much, Mike, for spending time with us today.
Thank you, John.
It's my pleasure.
My pleasure, John.